tutorial we will see how to upload the project into the controller using an USB and Ethernet connection. To do this we have to use a specific tool that is CFactory. Like CDesign can be run standalone from the start menu or called from inside the editor. Like before, if you start it from the start menu, you have to select the repository because it is the file that contains the binary file and the configuration that have to be uploaded into the controller. Well, in this exercise I prefer to start it from CStrategy. So first of all, we have to select the configuration we want to upload. So we select the chiller for compressors. We have already defined the input and output and the mask wizard, so we can continue and upload to device. This opens CFactory. It passes the repository that corresponding to the solution and configuration I have selected, and now we are almost ready to upload. We can start with the USB connection. You have to drop down the list and select the COM port corresponding to the Pico. The list is empty because I have not already connected the Pico to the PC. I'm doing it right now. You may need to wait for the installation of the driver. Here is carry controller, USB serial port, very good, and then upload. Start uploading. Upload completed. Okay, you can notice the speed that the project is uploaded into the controller. Much more faster compared to one tool. Okay, that's all for this. And by the way, you can see that Windows has started the autoplay regarding the public flash of the controller. In the introduction I told you that the public flash memory is seen by Windows as a removable disk, like a pen drive, so you can open and you can see the content of that memory. But this is not part of this tutorial, so close it. Now we have to check if the software works well in the controller. To show you this, I don't want to use a webcam. I will use a new feature of C Suite that is the remote PGD. I mentioned this also in the introduction. So start the browser, type the IP address of the controller. In this moment I have the controller connected to the PC also via Ethernet. Okay, this is not a problem. It states that make sure that the USB cable is disconnected. Why this? Because in this moment the file system of the public flash memory is mounted as a USB mass storage device. So in this moment the web server has no access to the web pages that are stored in the same file system. So, how to sort out this problem? Just disconnect the USB cable. Okay, I have done, and then reload. So, these are the web pages installed inside the controller. We will talk better about this in one of the last tutorials. Let's go straight to the remote PGD, and this is the mask that we can see also in the real controller. So temperature 18 degrees. In this controller I have a simulator of the connected to the first analog input, so I can change the temperature. Well, set point differential are zero, so we have to set them. So PRG, so we can enter in the menu. So these are the masks created by the mask wizard that we used just before. Let's go to the setting. If you remember, setting is protected by password. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Enter. Okay, we are inside. Now we can change set point to 12 degrees. Differential 4 degrees, and let's have a look to the input and output. So the 4 compressors are on. Now I reduce the temperature. You see that the 4 compressors starts 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then off. Well, so the project works also in the RIA controller. Probably you heard also the click-clack of the 4 relay regarding the compressor. Now we can try to upload the project into the CPICO using an Ethernet connection. First of all, we have to connect the CPICO and the PC in the same network through a local air network or with a direct connection, and then set a proper IP address to the two devices. If you are not skilled about this, it's better to contact your IT manager. Anyway, this slide summarizes the step you have to follow to give an IP address to the two devices, and there is also a video that shows how to do this in the appendix 6 section of the tutorial. Let's go back to CDesign. We have to check to have selected the right solution, repository and configuration, and then upload to device. The system starts CFactory. You have to select the Ethernet connection and select the IP address corresponding to the PICO where we wanted to install the project. The list is empty. Why? Because I have just 1 second ago I have disconnected my PC from the local network. Now I reconnect again, and here should appear the IP address of the PICO, that is 10.10.4.26, not wrong. I can use the discover function, and here is 10.10.4.26. Select that controller and upload. So what happened is what happened before with the USB connection. Also the speed is quite the same. Upload completed. You can check again in the remote PGD. Okay, very well, it works. Well, that's all also for this short tutorial where we have seen how to upload the project into the controller via USB and via Ethernet, and we have also have a look to the remote PGD. In the next video we will see how to simulate the project running in the real physical target, the CPICO, that is the debug online.